Hi, Carl. Thank you for joining me today. Could you please start by sharing your background and your current focus?
Thank you. Well, my background is I spent 25 good years in marketing and advertising. Started as a creative in advertising and worked with some large FMCG brands, in Publicis and Grey and a few others. In 97, I started in digital. And one of my first focus areas in digital was healthcare clients. So I worked with big pharmaceuticals and so on. My main focus now is to build my company, Refresh Wellbeing, which is a digital agency focusing on pharmaceutical companies and healthcare clients.
Great. Something I always like to ask people, how do you define social media, particularly with regards to use within an industry such as pharma?
Well, I mean, social media, I think it's obviously a lot of different things. It is the kind of social media, social networking that allows people to connect across multiple channels and privately reuse Facebook and other channels for that. But it also is can be used professionally, as for instance, using the platform the techniques with networking and allow healthcare professionals to connect and discuss various topics. So social media to me is one is kind of the phenomena, the platforms, the brands out there, but it's also instinct techniques to make people communicate better. For instance, project management tools and such like are great to bring healthcare professionals together around specific topics, and they can be applied in, for instance, clinical trials.
And what do you think are the most important challenges in pharma digital content?
Well, I see a couple of challenges. One is that because digital media, per definition, is quite fragmented, and the users would expect communication and messages and things to be more targeted to their specific needs, and that's exactly how they use these modern platforms. And developing digital content, obviously, you need to cater for various target audiences and their specific needs and requirements to be specific. And to address their specific needs. So that is a challenge if you're a brand manager, if you typically have developed your kind of display advertising campaign and your detail aid and a bit of Congress material. Suddenly, you're sitting there with a digital media plan, which allows you actually forces you to think how your content's going to be developed, not only from a technical perspective, also from consensus of messaging and relevance to a target audience. So it's going from being kind of you do 3-5 things as a brand manager to doing 10-15 things. And each media and opportunity is sort of unique. So it's I think the challenge is obviously on workload, but also on sort of starting thinking about content that is a bit more targeted to individual positions and or patient needs.
And what trends have you noted in regards to use of healthcare social media by different groups?
well, the obvious one is I mean, we are currently working on programs that are targeting patient groups where social media has a very important role, because not only as a means to reach the patients, but as a great opportunity for dialogue. So I think that is something we will see more of. Disease awareness programs to build awareness and competence around specific topics and so on and so forth. The other trend I think we will see is how pharmaceutical companies in particular is going to start leveraging social networking type of tools and mechanics to drive communication with healthcare professionals, whether it be around a clinical trial or data outcomes or to join forces around a specific topic. So I was thinking we'll see a lot of Facebook for physician type of initiatives, some of them driven by the pharmaceuticals, some of them driven by media owners and so on.
And what digital campaigns have you noted within pharma that you consider to be a success?
Well, I think there are a couple of really good examples. I note that J&J just closed down 360, which was a great example of an innovative way of using Facebook to support a specific patient need. And J&J have done other similar things, which I think has been really, really good. So that would be good examples. I think one of the campaigns we're doing now for branding smoking cessation I think is successful because it involves Facebook, it involves CRM, it involves a broad digital thinking and a broad digital marketing campaign using PPC as banner advertising. So I can see how digital really can work both towards patient targets and healthcare professional targets.
And conversely, what are the most common mistakes you see when being made when it comes to social media use within healthcare by both pharma and broader healthcare organisations?
The mistake is to look at social media in isolation and not integrated in your normal campaigns. I think that is a mistake because social media or digital is not, it should never be done in isolation. It should always be done in conjunction with your and integrated in your normal thinking and normal marketing plans. So the better way to do it is always to integrate it in your normal marketing plan and campaigns.
Carl, thank you very much for your time and for your insights today.
Thank you.